Luckily, practice was at 5 a.m., so I'm wide awake now.
Our fellow viewers, welcome back to another Mala Pink taste test video. So for this video, we are going to be trying out burgers.
We have five different burgers that Kate and I had picked up before this. We have McDonald's, Carl's Jr., Burger King, Jack in the Box, and Wendy's. So those are options. List, we have written all of the, you can't see that.
You can kind of see mine because it's darker.
We have all the different options written down, and so winner by the end who has them all right gets to
or the most right.
Yes, gets a prize. Not bad.
I'm not.
I gotta know what this is.
I definitely know what this is.
I'm near positive I know what this is.
I put Burger King.
I put Burger King.
I put McDonald's.
Not McDonald's.
Why are we gonna? We're gonna find out in just a little bit.
Are you gonna finish that?
No. You gonna eat that?
Okay. Just be
smashing
on the ground.
Number two.
I don't.
Whoa.
Absolutely.
Oh wow.
I really liked my first bite, but when I tasted that mustard, it must have just punched me in the face.
A little too much mustard.
No, see, I like the mustard. I do enjoy that little flair. I mean, I always like the taste of mustard. Like I put on everything.
Yeah, Jack in the Box.
Yeah, Kate and I both put Jack in the Box over Carl's Jr.
I'm so gonna.
I've never had a Jack in the Box burger before. This was my first time.
It was a little out of my comfort zone.
I didn't recognize it.
I'm gonna be quite frank.
Okay. Actually, first impressions of this is. What?
We're just laughing because we remembered the one where we had to order the double patty.
What is the double patty? For those of you who have no idea what they were just saying, allow me to explain. So when Kate and Mason went to Carl's Jr., they were out of single patty burgers, so they had to order a double patty, which is why they knew which burger it was.
Definitely the best burger so far.
Oh, I like it a lot too.
Very good. Wow. I said Carl's Jr.
I said potentially Carl's Jr., but I had already written that down. So, they know it's Carl's Jr.
We know.
How about we all just get that point? Because you guys knew it, and I suspected.
Yeah.
So we all just get that point.
Kate and I are gonna tie.
Okay. So the reason why I think I know what this is because I have watched The Founder, which is a documentary, it's like a bio documentary about McDonald's.
I know that it's McDonald's just because I haven't watched The Founder, but it's obviously McDonald's.
Oh shoot, I'm really screwed for that one. I definitely lost this game.
We already knew this was Wendy's as well.
Okay.
Because it costs $5. And we're like, what the heck? We asked for a cheeseburger. Why is it $5?
First impressions, everybody.
I like that there's a tomato on it. I'm a big tomato
guy. I
can
tell you about tomatoes. Lettuce, I don't understand lettuce. Doesn't taste like anything. There's no nutritional value. I don't want it on my burger.
It's texture.
I don't care about the texture.
It's the crunch factor.
It's good.
Here's the thing. Mason,
I get
if you're making
crunch factor
for my pickles.
No, I do not put lettuce on my burger.
Mason,
if it's on, I will take it off. I'm not that picky.
Have you ever had like a fancy burger with lettuce on it?
Yes.
What did you think of it?
I didn't care about the lettuce. If it's on there, I wouldn't care.
What about a little big burger? They have that little like.
Yeah, I don't care. It doesn't bother me, but I'm like, it would taste the exact same if it was not on there.
But it wouldn't, it'd be worse.
Like a tomato adds flavor. Pickles add flavor.
I think we just have refined palates.
Yeah.
We're better than him.
This is my favorite one so far. I like this a lot.
I agree with that. This is my favorite one so far. I'm a little surprised.
I got the sauce on my socks.
What's Carl's?
No.
Oh, there's a bat here coming to visit. It's my friend.
It's so nasty.
If you're wondering why Mason says it was his friend, it's because he's convinced he's Batman. In his head, there's something in there telling him.
Don't tell him.
Guys, this is secretly an episode of Dr. Phil. Where we're trying to convince him that
look,
he's
do you think
Batman.
You're Bruce Wayne?
Guys, don't tell him. We're gonna post this. They're gonna know that I'm Batman now.
Okay.
We're just joking around. No way I'm Batman.
Oh, help us.
This is actually Dr. Phil, though.
This is
the real Dr. Phil. I'm just an extra, guys.
So, what do you think of Batman?
I just gotta, Katie gotta go.
Oh, yeah.
Everybody, time for the big reveal. Since I was the one who most likely lost, I will be reading off the plates. Plate number one was
King.
Burger King.
Burger King.
Yeah. All right, the second plate is Jack in the Box. Carl's Jr. is plate number three.
That's 3 points.
McDonald's plate number four. We all know Wendy's plate number five. Ooh, it's dripping. Plate number five is Wendy's. So, do you know what that leaves us, gentlemen and ladies? And anybody else watching here?
We're gonna have a dunk contest.
No,
find out who the winner
is. No.
Cut that, scratch that.
Do you know what that means, ladies and gentlemen? That means I get to decide the tiebreaker.
Yeah.
Everyone is gonna hate this idea. Everybody in the room, including myself. So this
so
will
what
be.
The so why don't we do something we enjoy?
No. This will be a three-part
breath holding contest.
No.
Shut up.
This will be a three-part tiebreaker, okay? And within the three parts, each part is a challenge. There will be three challenges if you didn't get that by the three parts. First challenge is the first person to chug and finish a sparkling water. We'll get a point if you don't get to say no here.
Go!
I'll try wearing that.
So that will be the first challenge. The second challenge, which kind of plays the Mason's strength, will be how many baskets can you make in 30 seconds?
Oh. I won, right?
That's nice.
Okay, and the winner of that will receive...
Like 3 points or what?
What's that?
What's your
finale? We'll figure that out. And then the finale will be determined by a ping pong game.
Sorry.
Behold, the winner. Are we surprised?
Yes.
No, I'm not that mad about it. I'll get over it. You know, you live and you learn, another day, another game. You know, I was really, thought I had it for a second, but slipped away. And it's just a point, but mad, I won't say I'm mad now. It's a learning opportunity for sure.